You. She also knows how to come off pressure. She's flat fucking refusing.
Wow, that was easy.
You got the fucking idea now? That was dumb. Come on. Move your feet.
Now you don't want to get out.
Now you need to fucking deal in there. Yep, I don't want to see it.
A bunch of people tagged me in this video, so I wanted to do a quick response to this with a short tutorial on trailer loading because I see a lot of people loading this way and using the same justifications. And one justification I wanted to bring up is the fact that this person is saying that the trailer is a safe place because they release all pressure in the trailer. This is not any more true than it would be to call someone who is leading you into a cellar at gunpoint saying that they're taking you to a safe place. Because they take the gun off of you down in the cellar. That's not how it works. Horses are flight animals. A tiny little rattly dark box where they are trapped is never going to feel like a safe place, especially if they are forced inside of it, which is why you can hear this horse panicking and rattling around so much in the video before this one. So anyways, I'll show you how I teach my horses how to trailer load and how you get them comfortable with trailer loading so they're not crashing around being dangerous like in the aforementioned video, because that is not safe. The horse is not quiet, and that is not how you get good, consistent trailer loading over the course of years. And if you ever get in an emergency situation where the horse is even more scared than usual, then you're really in trouble because they are already terrified of the trailer and you've put yourself at a disadvantage. So I sincerely hope the person who made the prior video is willing to consider these methods, because you'll see that my horses load better, and so clearly they work better. This is my rescue gelding, Milo, who used to be really bad about trailer loading to the point where he'd rear and spin and run away. And as you can see, that's been fixed, and we've used positive reinforcement to fix this. And this is my youngster, Banksy, in one of his first few sessions with the trailer. And as you can see, he hops right in. This is after only a few trials. It was about a 10 to 15 minute session. Here, I have to hold him back because he's that eager, and this is kind of where we're at now. He'll load himself if you'll let him, and he tries to get in too early because the trailer has become such a rewarding place. And this is all done by making it fun for them to get in, rewarding them for the try and not forcing them or making it something stressful, because the trailer is a natural fear. This is a client horse that I had that had a very bad trailering experience and as a result became extremely difficult and dangerous to load. I taught her how to trailer load again at Liberty using a target stick and some vocal cues and positive reinforcement. And as you can see, she started self-loading within two sessions. And this is only the second session here that I am showing. The first session was a short one and we did it with a rope on initially, but no pressure. And this is how I taught her to load. I'm not even near the trailer. I'm at the window calling to her, and she loaded herself in this last clip. If you want to see the full videos, you can check it out on my YouTube.